Hello dear friends, in this session we are going to focus on cyber security. Cyber security means the security of information that is there in computer system, or it is simply called computer information security, or the information technology security, or we also call it as electronic information security. So how to secure our data? How to protect our data from unauthorized access, that we are going to understand in this session. So before understanding the cyber security, we must know what are the different types of crimes, how they perform the crimes, how cyber criminal perform the crime, and how to protect our data from that different crimes. If you are not able to secure your data, then you will be called as an illiterate person. Of being a computer user, you can also called as a computer illiterate person. Before some days, if you are not able to handle computer, if you are not able to use the computer or mobile, you are called illiterate person. But nowadays, if you are not able to protect your data, you will be called as an illiterate person. So being a literate person, you must know how to secure your data and how to secure our data from different cyber crimes. So first we focus on the cyber crime, what is called cyber crime, the different kinds of cyber crime, and then in our next session we will focus on the different cyber security measures. So let's start with PowerPoint presentation so that we will understand what is cyber crime, why the cyber crimes happens, who actually does the cyber crime, what is the profile of cyber crime, and what are the different types of cyber crime. So let's start with PowerPoint presentation. So here we are going to understand the cyber crime and cyber security. So these are the contents of this session that we are going to understand. First we are going to learn what is cyber crime and cyber security. Then we focus on introduction of cyber crime, then types of cyber crime and the different types of cyber crime such as fake mail, fake SMS, fake call, etc. So what is cyber crime? Before understanding the term cyber crime, first we focus on why learn about cyber crime. What is the need of understanding the cyber crime? Because you know, everybody is using computers, everybody is using smartphones, different devices they are using, and using the different devices and computer, someone is committing the crimes and we suffer to that crimes. So how to protect from such crimes that happens on internet, with the help of internet or with the help of computers, how to protect our data from such crimes, that we are going to understand first. So as you know, everybody is using computer. From who is using computer? From white collar criminal to terrorist organization, and from youngsters to adult, everybody is using computer. Okay. One particular terrorist is also knows how to use computer to perform a commit a particular crime or to commit a particular crime. We must know how to secure ourselves from such crimes. Then conventional crimes, as you know, conventional crimes such as forgery, extortion or kidnapping, which can also be committed with the help of computers. Computer can also be used for committing such kind of crimes. Kidnapping can be performed with the help of computers by getting some information on internet, where is that person, how we can kidnap that, where is the actual location of that person. We can identify the location of person for kidnapping with the help of computers. We can extort or we can copy the data of a particular user using internet or using the computers or the different smart systems available with us. Then new generation is growing up with computers. Then, and the most important part is, all the financial transactions are depend on internet, are converted on internet, are moving on internet. That's why it is very important to learn about cybercrime. So what different cybercrimes are there and how the cyber crimes performs and how to secure our data from that unauthorized cyber crimes. Okay, what is called cyber crime? Cyber means what? Cyber means a computer generated, or it is called virtual or fake. The meaning of word cyber is computer related or computer generated or virtual or fake, or electronic information related is also called cyber. A crime performed with the help of computer program, computer or the programs available on the computer and through internet is called cyber crime. All crimes performed by, what is the purpose of performing crime? The purpose is by misuse of electronic media with the purpose of controlling function of computer or computer system. Means I want to control another system by sitting here. I want to disturb the information available on another system by sitting here. That's why I try to commit some crime by sitting on this computer, so that I will able to understand, I will able to access the unauthorized data which is there on another computer. Or I want to know what that particular user is doing on another computer. So for that, the crime is performed for misusing the electronic media. In short, a computer crime is any crime where computer is a target, computer is a tool of crime, and computer is a incidental to crime. Means here, a computer can be used as a tool, like we use knives, like we use gun for committing crimes in real life. Here, a crime can be performed, made with the help of computers. A computer is called a tool, like a gun or like a knife. Computer can be a tool for committing crimes. So, crime committed with the help of computers are called cybercrime. So, where the computer is target, the crime where computer is target is called cybercrime. Or where generally computer is used as a tool for committing crimes. Okay. What is the profile of cyber criminal? Who actually does the cyber crime? Generally, the disappointed or the dissatisfied or unhappy employees of a particular organization commit the crime. Teenagers or youngsters, being a curiosity, they commit the crime. Political hackers also commit the crime. Professional hackers who knows the information technology very well, who knows the knowledge of a particular technology very well, they try to commit the crimes. Business competitors can commit the cyber crime. Your ex-boyfriend can also commit the crime. A divorced husband can also commit the crime, cyber crime. So these are the profile of cyber crime. Then who is the sufferer, who is the victim of that cyber crimes? Generally, very innocent and easy to fool people are the sufferers of cybercrime, which is called gullible people. Then desperados, the desperados people and the greedy people can also be a sufferers of cybercrime. Desperados is what in Marathi we call it as a gangster or nirashagrast people who sufferers of cybercrime. Unskilled and unexperienced person who don't know how to handle information technology in a proper manner, how to use the computer system in a proper manner, can also be a sufferer of cyber crime. Or inexperienced person can be a sufferer of cyber crime. Or unlucky people can be a sufferer of cyber crime. A computer crime is vulnerable, is dangerous, very helpless, is risky because of these reasons. Because of secrecy of information, everyone want to secure his information on computer, and someone want to access his secure information. We want to secret our information, we want to keep our information secret in computer. Because of computer storage capacity is increasing day by day, we wanted to store everything on computer. We want to store all our documents, all our password, all transactions. We want to keep on computer. So because of increased storage capacity, everything we want to store on computer, so that we will be able to access anywhere those information. there are some weakness in operating system. Because of that, the crime happens. That crime is dangerous. There may be some lacunas in system, and your system can allow us to allow some other people to access your information without your permission because of such weaknesses in operating system. Lack of awarenesses, the people not aware about the information technology rules or how to handle the system properly. They are not understanding how system can be operated in a secure way. They don't have knowledge. Because of that, the computer crime is very dangerous, helpless. So then we focus on the different types of cybercrime. This list shows you the different category of cybercrimes. First is hacking. So we'll focus on what is called hacking in detail in next slide. First, here we only focus on what are the different types of cybercrime. The second is denial of service attack. Then virus dissemination, software piracy, pornography, IRC crime, credit card fraud, then debt extortion, phishing, cyber stalking, cyber dissemination, defamation, threatening, and salami attack. All are the different category of cyber crimes. So one by one we focus on each of the cyber crime listed in previous slide. First we discuss on what is cyber dissemination. The cyber dissemination is what? It is a malicious software, a dangerous software, unauthorized software that attacks itself to other software. A software designed to attack on another software. To that, they are able to access your information with that malicious software. One of the software name is called virus, worms, Trojan horse, time bomb, logic bomb, rabbit, bacterium, and the malicious software. These are the different examples of virus. So these viruses are generally a program written by some criminals, and they send that program to your machine so that program will harm you, will disturb your information, may delete your information, may copy your information to another location, or may copy your information and send a mail to a criminal. So for that they have prepared a program. Such programs are called virus, a virus dissemination. Creating and sending a virus program from one machine to another machine is called virus dissemination. Then the second types of crime is hacking. So what is hacking? Hacking means trying to access the illegal information, trying to access the information which is there on another computer. I want to know what that person is actually doing in his computer. If I able to know that what he is doing, then I can disturb him, I can access his personal information, I can commit a crime on him without the permission of computer owner or user, trying to access the illegal information into a computer system or what that person is actually doing here. I want to see what is there in computer, in that particular computer, on this computer. So this is called hacking. If I able to access the information available on this computer by sitting here, so such information, such crime is called hacking. Then the second category of crime is called the denial of service attack. It is also one of the important crime through which the criminal try to stop your service, whatever the internet connection or service that you are using at your home or at your workplace. The criminal try to stop that service by sending unwanted data to your internet line or sending unwanted data to your mail by sending a spam mail will be sent to you, so that you will not able to use your actual mail service. You will see there unwanted mails which are there in your mailbox. So trying to disturb you, trying to stop the service that you are using, trying to stop the program that you are using, that is called denial of service attack. Then software piracy is another important cyber crime. Illegal accessing of the legal softwares, illegally using the legal software is called cyber piracy. means Windows operating system is an example of legal software. While using Windows operating system, you have to use the operating system license, you have to purchase the operating system, or some of the software such as MS Word, MS PowerPoint, that you have to purchase before using it. Some of these softwares are not free. You have to use those software, you have to purchase those software, or you are doing particular business, and for that business you are not purchase a software, and you are copying, you have made a copy of particular software and you are using that software illegally. That is called cyber piracy. Means cyber piracy is also a theft of software. You copied a software from someone's computer and you are using that computer in your machine through the illegal copying of general program or counterfeiting, bogus fake and distribution of product intended to pass for the original. Retail revenues losses worldwide are ever increasing due to this crime. Can be done in various ways: end user copying, hard disk loading, counterfeiting, bogus bug, means copying the information which is there on this system in a pen drive or a remote copy, or accessing that information by sitting on another computer is called software piracy. Or downloading the illegal software and using that illegal software, that is also a cyber piracy. That is also a software piracy. Then the next category of cyber crime is pornography. It is also another important cyber crime. Some illegal material, pornographic contents, which can be easily added on internet for marketing purpose, for encouraging customer to access their website. Anybody including children can log on to the internet and access website with pornographic content with a flying top, with a click of mouse. But adding the pornographic content on website is a crime, is a major crime, and who commit that crime will be punished by the Information Technology Act 2000. What are the different acts that we are going to understand in our next session? Then the next category of crime is IRC crime, that is Internet Relay Chat crime. Trying to access the chat box of another person, if some chatting is performed between the two person, and we want someone is accessing your chatting, your personal chatting, by entering into your chat room, such crime is called internet relay crime. A criminal uses it for meeting with person. Hacker use it for discussing their technique. In order to harass women, her telephone number is given to other as if she want to be a friend mate. Then the next crime is credit card fraud. This is another important fraud. Through the credit card, if someone has stolen your credit card, or someone has stolen your credit card number and the backside pin which is printed on the credit card, they can easily perform a transaction. Some site only allows to use perform the transaction with the help of credit card number and pin number. They will not ask for the OTP, and then if you are not able to secure your credit card, if someone has stolen your credit card, or if you are enter the credit card somewhere on website and that credit card information is accessed by someone, so then they can illegally access your credit card, illegally use your credit card for doing transaction over internet. So this is also one of the important cyber crime. Then the next cyber crime is net extortion. Copying the company's confidential data in order to extort said company for a huge amount. Means try to access the confidential information of a particular company is called net extortion. And by accessing such confidential information about a particular company, we can commit the crime on that company, or we can try to disturb that company, try to stop that particular company. The next type of crime is phishing. Phishing is what? In Marathi it is called fason. Sometimes we got a mail from unauthorized person, and in that mail some link may be there, and if you click on the link, you will get your bank page. but it may not be your actual bank page. It is a similar site created by that unauthorized user, and they have asked to perform a transaction on this page. And while not validating that, whether it is actual bank page or some illegal website, by not confirming it, if you made some transaction on this page, if you try to made some transaction on this page, if you enter your username and password here and try to log in, so your actual username and password will be copied by that unauthorized user who is sending a mail to your mail ID. So before performing any transaction online, you must have to confirm whether that website is a secure website, whether that website is actual bank website or not. And if you not confirm it, you will be sufferer of cyber crime. Okay, so this is called phishing. Then sometimes a phishing mail is arrives to your mail ID. Sometimes some unauthorized user, illegal users, a company send you a mail that you got a lottery of that particular dollar, and you confirm that, and without confirming that, you faith on them and you provide your actual proper information to that user ID by mail without realizing that whether you got such mail or not. You have to remember that you cannot get anything on internet free. For getting some money, you have to do some hard work. A lottery, you cannot get any lottery online. Okay, so you should understand the content of the mail that you received, phishing mail, and you have to confirm that whether that mail is actual mail, whether you actually got such lottery. This is an example of phishing email. Then the next type of cybercrime is spoofing. The spoofing is what? Getting one computer on a network to pretend to have the identity or another computer. Means try to access the information which is there on another computer by without intimating him or without giving the knowledge to him. Then the next crime is cyber stalking. Cyber stalking is what? Criminal follows the victim by sending email, entering the chat room frequently, etc. is called cyber stalking. Then the next is cyber dissemination, which is also called insult. Someone try to insult you by sending mail and accessing your website, accessing your Facebook account or WhatsApp account, etc. Then the next category of crime is the fake emails, fake SMS and fake calls. Someone can access your email ID. By using your email ID, it is possible that by using your email ID, someone can send you mail. By using your mobile number, someone can send you a mail to another person, etc. Similar to that, fake call can be also made by using your number. There are some websites available on the internet through that a criminal can directly send a SMS by using your mobile number. By using your mobile number, they can make a call to another person. So these are the different category of crimes. I hope you understand. Thank you.